Good day, everyone. My name is Fyodor Ivanov, and I'm glad to present you our work under the title A New Code-Based Cryptosystem. This is a joint work with Grigory Kabatyansky from Skolkov Institute of Science and Technology and Evgeny Kruk from National Research University High School of Economics. And I'm also an associate professor of High School of Economics. The outline, sorry. Can you see the next slide? Because no, I cannot.
We see a white screen.
It's very interesting. Let me try again. Sorry. It's unusual. Let me try to reopen. And now?
Now, apparently, you are not sharing your screen.
Sorry. Yes.
Okay, here we are.
No. Okay, I'm sorry. Sorry for the inconveniences. This is the outline of my presentation. First of all, I'll say just a few words about traditional Mercalis cryptosystems. Then I also say just some important facts about one of the promising types of an attacks against Mercalis cryptosystem, namely information set decoding attack. Then I'll formulate some problems about how we can improve the security of Mercalis cryptosystem. And our approach is to use an arbitrary error vector. It means that we are trying to increase the weight of an error vector and make it higher than correction capacity of code T. Then we will formulate the basic construction of the new cryptosystem. We will call it a prototype cryptosystem. In fact, it's rather weak, but it gives us, in our opinion, a good idea how we can construct a new types of Mercalis cryptosystem. For this type of cryptosystem, I'll describe some attack based on matrix inversion. Then I'll formulate a syndrome-based attack, which is critical for this type of cryptosystem. And after that, I'll construct a new modified version of the previous cryptosystem, which can be broken by the syndrome-based attack. I'll consider it, in fact, I'll show you another type of attack based on the image of linear operator that can break this type of cryptosystem. After it, I'll make some conclusions, based on this conclusion, I'll construct new modified version of the cryptosystem that can be broken by neither a linear operator attack or a syndrome-based attack. Because this version of cryptosystem is a little bit more complicated, I'll formulate some description of the elements of this cryptosystem. I'll show you some syndrome-based attack examples, and after all, I will say some concluding words. Okay, this is a well-known construction of a traditional Mercalis cryptosystem. I'll not stop here since of lack of time, but just one thing that I want to mention that in this case, the open key is G prime, which is a product of three matrices. And it should be mentioned that the code G prime has the same correction properties as the original code. Since we multiply hidden matrix G in left side by not non-singular matrix S, it means that we make some invertible linear operation on the rows of the secret matrix, and P is just some permutation matrix. It means that codes defined by generator matrix G, which is secret one, and open matrix G prime are permutation equivalent. And in this case, we have a well-known attack. It's called information set decoding attack. The main idea of this attack is to find some informational set which is free of errors. And if we can do it, then we can recover our plain text by the expression in the step 3. And it's rather simple to calculate the probability of having no errors in chosen car indexes, which is the informational set. This is the probability P, P sub S, and thus the average number of attempts to break original Mac-Ali script system is 1 divided this probability. But of course, there are some optimization or improvements of the original information set decoding attacks. Here I just mentioned two papers, and I don't know, but in my point of view, the best result now is formulated by May, Alexander May, in 2012, and the exponent complexity is something like code length divided by 20. But and now we will formulate the main problem, the main issue for us, and the problem is how we can modify the original Mac-Ali script system to make ISD attack more complex or even impossible. And in other words, the question can be formulated as follows. How to make the security of the crypto system is much closer to the hardness of the maximum likelihood decoding than the original Mac-Ali crypto system. And of course, one of the obvious ways how we can do it, we need to increase T and make it greater than the half of the minimum distance or even arbitrary. It means that if we want to increase the complexity of attack of Mac-Ali script system, we should consider error vectors with an arbitrary weight. And there are some known approaches in this direction. This is two papers. The first approach was presented by Evgeny Krug in 1993, but unfortunately, 5 years later, there was found an attack by Uli Zorger, and they published the paper when it was shown that this crypto system can be reduced to the original Mac-Ali one. And now we are going to formulate the base prototype crypto system, and it consists of the open key of this crypto system consists of two matrices, G prime and G prime sub one. And as you can see here, we multiply the hidden generator matrix G of the secret code by some invertible N times N matrix, but we do it in right side. It means that in this case, the code defined by matrix G prime has an approximately random structure, and the experiments show that this code, the parameter of this code lies near from Warshimov-Gilbert bound. And also the main idea is in matrix G prime 1. And in this case, we use matrix G0, and matrix G0 consists of n code words of the original code C. And in this case, we have encryption and decryption algorithms. They are described here. The encryption is very simple, and the but unfortunately, in this case, just for this case, we should choose vector E, the error vector E, with weight is at most T. In the next types of the crypto system, we overcome this drawback. And the decryption is as follows. We first multiply the ciphertext by the inversion of matrix M, and we have this triple sum. And since matrix, since vector E multiplied by P has weight at most T, then we can decode it applying some polynomial time decoding algorithm of code C, and to recover plain text U in the fourth step of this algorithm. And the interesting attack which was found against this crypto system is as follows. Let us assume that the matrix G0 minus P, where P is some permutation, is non-singular. In this case, the following attack can be implemented. First of all, we will multiply ciphertext C by the inverse of the matrix G prime 1. And in this case, we have the matrix as it's shown in the second point. And we have the following theorem that was proved in the paper, that the code defined by generator matrix G and the code defined by generator matrix G multiplied by G0 minus P, the inverse of this matrix, are permutation equivalent. It means that in this case, we can decode our cryptosystem just applying a simple informational set decoding algorithm and reduce this cryptosystem to original Michaelis one. And it means that we should choose this matrix G0 minus P is singular. And there is example how we can do it. Of course, it's just one of the a number of examples. You can, of course, construct your own one. And I'm not stopped here for a long time. And now I show you the syndrome-based attack, which is the critical for this type of cryptosystem, and which is reduces it to the original Michaelis cryptosystem. In this case, intruder or if compute the parity check matrix H prime for an open generator matrix G prime, and she obtains the following syndrome equation, usual syndrome equation. And here we can see that code G tilde with generator matrix P multiplied by transpose of H multiplied by transpose of S has the same properties as the original code C. And in this case, we can decode this code or open this cryptosystem by conventional ISD decoding algorithm. And now how we can overcome this problem. In order to improve this prototype cryptosystem, we should take the structure of the matrix G prime 1 a little bit more complicated. Namely, let us consider the matrix G prime 1 in the form presented in the slide, where matrix W is some non-singular square matrix. D is T diagonal matrix. It means that it has T ones in the main diagonal, and other components are the same in the previous prototype cryptosystem. And in this system, we also have two public matrices. First one is S in the previous type of cryptosystem, and the second one is a little bit more complicated. And the encryption and decryption looks like in the previous looks like as ones of the previous type of cryptosystem. And but now in this case we can choose vector E with an arbitrary weight. We can do it since the multiplication E on W on D on P has weight at most T. That's why in this case we can use any error vector and decode it just applying an original simple decoding algorithm of code C. And in this case, here is shown that the syndrome-based attack cannot be applied since in the this syndrome equation, if confined, of course, if confined the vector error vector in the form E multiplied by W multiplied by D multiplied by T. This is a vector of weight T, but she cannot extract the vector E from this multiplication since all other multipliers are unknown for her. But in fact, in this case, we have another type of attack, and this attack can be formulated due to the very small rank of matrix G prime 1. It has, it's obvious that it has rank T since D is a diagonal matrix. And it means that for any error vector E, vector E multiplied by G prime sub 1 has just generates just Q in the power of T different vectors. And also the following theorem was proved that for any vector E, there exists a unique solution X prime such that the difference between ciphertext and this unique solution lies in code C. And this solution can be chosen from the image of this matrix. It means that if can find a plain text U, just applying at most Q in the power of the attempts, where Q is the number of errors. Of course, now I'll formulate some remarks, some middle concluding remarks. The main advantage of the previous type of crypto system that we can make vector E with an arbitrary weight. But the main drawback is that the intruder can find plain text U just applying at most Q in the power of T ranks. And this fact is due to the very small rank of matrix G prime 1. And the natural question is, can we increase the rank of this matrix while still remaining vector E arbitrary? And the answer to this question is yes. And now I formulate you, show you the final type of cryptosystem. We call it upgrading of the cryptosystem. And in this case, let us show how we can modify matrix G prime 1 to obtain rank n minus k instead of t. For this purpose, let us consider the following matrix G prime 2 with this form, which looks like the form as in the previous type of crypto system. But in this case, we choose two matrices Q and T with special structure. We choose matrix singular, but we require that multiplication of these two matrices has the following form. It means that the multiplication of this matrix results in the matrix which has zero columns in the positions of some informational set of code C, and all other columns forms some non-singular n times n minus k full rank matrix. And of course, the natural question is how we can construct this the matrix with the following structure. One of the results is presented here. We can construct it just by taking columns which are placed in the position of informational set, and construct some generator matrix by these columns. And if we found the parity check matrix for this generator matrix, we can construct matrix Q with the following form, where capital L is any arbitrary full rank matrix. And it's obvious that matrix Q multiplied by T has zero column set positions of the informational sets, and all other columns form full rank matrix. And in this case, the improved version of the crypto system is as follows. We also have two parts of the open key, and the private key is, as usual, a factorization of all these matrices plus a given fixed informational set. The encryption and decryption are presented here, and the main idea that if we apply any error vector with an arbitrary weight, this operation E multiplied by G prime 2 results in positions free of error for a given informational set, which is an intruder. And of course, it's obvious to show that the traditional ISD attack cannot be applied in this situation, because we need to find not any informational set free of errors, but a fixed informational set free of errors. But in this case, also syndrome-based attack is infeasible. Here I present some syndrome-based equation for this situation. And here we should notice that the parity check matrix is equals to H, which is the parity check matrix of the original Michaelis crypto system with a hidden code output multiplied by this singular matrix Q multiplied by T. And here I present some results. This is the results for rather short BCH code where I can calculate the spectrum precisely. And here the green, the blue curve, the blue curve is the spectrum for original BCH code with length 31. And the other curves are shows the spectrum of the codes defined by H multiplied by transpose of Q, Q multiplied by T. And here we can see that this matrix, this transformation results in approximately random code, and there are some cases when these codes have a smaller number of parity checks when spectrum is higher. And here is some table results for this case. And here we can see that when we choose 500 different transposes, and there are some cases when the likeness of parity checks equals to 2. And also here you can see that the average minimal distance of the obtained codes are rather close to Varshamov-Gilbert bound. And here is the results of a little bit longer codes. The situation is as in the previous slides. And also the resulting codes are rather close to Varshamov-Gilbert bound instead of BCH codes, which has parameters rather better than for middle lengths, the parameters of BCH codes is rather better. And if we assume that the complexity of our new crypto system is Q multiplied by minimum of K and minus K, then we can formulate this example. And this example shows that instead of using a traditional GOPA code that corrects 50 errors, here we can use an BCH code that corrects only 9 errors. And in this case, the length of the open key will be approximately 13 times smaller. And this is the conclusion of my presentation. The main advantage of the proposed crypto system that it is in fact code independent. That's why it can be combined for any other ideas that reduces the length of the open key in Mahalis crypto system. Okay, that's all. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Fedor.